It's the Golfin Around Radio Hour! Sponsored by Team USA Worldwide Amateur Golf Championships. Play your way to Scotland, July 31st at the Wheeling Country Club. Team USA Worldwide Amateur Golf Championships.com. Gaylord Golf Mecca.com. Gaylord Golf Mecca.com. Come experience golf paradise. Zero friction golf balls, gloves, tees, bags, and more. Squares Golf Shoes. The world's greatest golf shoe. Gustbusters Golf Umbrellas. Welcome back to the Golfin' Around Radio Hour here on Fox Sports Net, Wheeling, Pittsburgh. I'm your host, Tank. And you know what? Golf season really is just starting here in June. Isn't that crazy in Wheeling, Pittsburgh? People are just getting out on the tracks. But guess what? The old tanker took a driver, man, and I cracked one up to the Upper Peninsula, in Upper Michigan, in Gaylord, Michigan, and just beautiful by Lake Michigan. And if you don't know who or where Lake Michigan is, or where Gaylord, the golf mecca, is, well, guess what? My good buddy Greg's with me right now, sitting in a golf cart here on the 19th hole on the Golfin' Around Radio Hour. And Greg knows everything about Michigan golf and Gaylord golf mecca. Did you grow up in Michigan?
I did. I grew up in the southwest corner, down straight across from Chicago.
So if I say, go Buckeyes, you do what?
Oh, I would cringe. But I'm a Michigan State guy, so I'm a...
You just did cringe.
I'm you should your... Yeah, well, it's just the whole state of Ohio could, you know, disappear, and we could go straight to Texas or something.
There you go. You know Michigan State Spartans, right?
Yes, that's where I went to school.
The Sparties sent us one hell of a running back a couple years ago, and Le'Veon Bell.
Le'Veon, yeah.
Then he lost his mind and riding jet skis thinking he's Walter Payton, and now he's probably out of the league.
Well, you know, he's originally from Ohio. That's probably part of the problem.
That his head cracked like a Buckeye.
He's from Reynoldsburg or something like that, which I think it's outside of Columbus or something.
The Burg of Reynolds.
Yeah.
I like that. Well, you know, this is so beautiful. I come up to Michigan all the time, folks, to golf. I love it up here. There's a reason I love it. And I can articulate it, but Greg can best because he knows Gaylord, the golf mecca. Why would somebody get in a car and drive from Wheeling, Steubenville, Pittsburgh to come up here? It's probably about 6 hours. Yeah. Why?
Yeah, well, there's June, July, and August, and we're still in the Lower Peninsula. There's a whole other Upper Peninsula, but we're in the top of the Lower Peninsula, basically. But we call it, if you look, there's a bridge that goes from the Lower Peninsula to the Upper Peninsula. It's called the Mackinac Bridge. And if you live below it, you're a troll. If you live above it, you're a youper.
So I'm living. Yeah. I'm learning.
So
here.
You're a troll. Yeah,
I'm a troll.
Anyway, and Gaylord is just a. What it is we have kind of this great summer situation up here, where you have light. We're right on the edge of the time zone, Eastern time zone, so it stays light till like 9:20, 9:30 at night. So you can play golf for a really long time up here, all day long, and it never gets really, really hot. It never gets 85-ish, 90-ish. You're never like too hot to play. And we always have these great, cold, nice, crisp mornings like this, which makes you feel good, and you have energy, and you go play your first 18.
There's nothing worse than waking
up. Second 18.
Like in Myrtle Beach or Florida, you wake up first thing in the morning, you take a shower, you walk outside, and the humidity just rolls over you, and you're uncomfortable. From the second you walk out on the golf, Myrtle Beach gets extremely hot, June, July, and August. So I guess what I'm telling you Golfin' Around Radio Hours listeners, maybe point the old car north or get on an airplane. You've got a great airport here.
Cherry Capital Airport has direct flights from a lot of places, including Texas. But it's and from the East Coast, you can get here relatively easy, even if you got to go through Detroit. But it's really pretty quick. And you can, you know, play golf all day. It's just never one of those situations where, oh, it's too hot or it's too crummy. It's just really beautiful. I mean, like, my favorite time to play up here is 4 o'clock in the evening. You play at 4 o'clock and then you can go to dinner afterwards.
Yeah, right.
You get a cut rate and you got the whole thing going for you.
Especially, like, on a Sunday evening. Oh, there's nobody on a golf course.
No. And it's like you own it. You own this piece of... Northern Michigan real estate, and it's...
I would call peace
really
a heaven.
Cool. It's really nice. Yeah.
You know, there's an alpine-y feel to the town. We've got a lot of skiing up here.
Yeah.
We're staying... Am I saying it right? The Otsego? Otsego?
No, Otsego.
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 I don't speak Otsegian, so yeah, I don't know how to pronounce it.
They put out like an alpine theme out here when they built this place. And then the town kind of adopted it because this resort came here and built this alpine feel. You know, one of the original investors was some guy from Switzerland or something, so they decided to have this alpine thing.
I saw that coming in that Gaylord actually has a sister city in Switzerland. Yeah. But there's a great, quaint feel here in Gaylord, Michigan. Calm, relaxed, nobody's beeping and honking and car fumes. It's very tranquil, which translates to your golf game, right?
It should. It doesn't always, but it should.
It should.
Yeah, I mean, it's I don't know, I always just feel good up here. I sleep great up here for some reason, because it just always seems like it's kind of cool and comfortable at night, and then in the day you get some sunshine and you go play golf. I mean, it's really relaxing, and, you know, they could call Gaylord Relaxville or whatever, but it's kind of a
Chillville.
Yeah, it's really kind of, and it's, you know, there's not too busy. You're right about that. It has great restaurants, and you know, it has all the things golfers want. It's got a couple bars that stay open late. It's got, you know,
where did we eat last night?
We ate at a place called Benetham's.
What's it? All these names, I can't, you know, I'm not Norwegian. I'm Irish. Yeah. I'm Swiss, but whatever.
We got a different group up here. It's a little diversified, but
what a steakhouse!
Yeah, it's a wonderful restaurant. It's easily one of the best in Northern Michigan. Really, it really is. And you know, they treat you right. They treat you really nice. And you know, they don't care if you wear golf clothes. And and yet you still get a fine dining experience. I mean, you get. You know, but there's no fancy tablecloths. It's just a nice wooden table, and it's sit down and
chow.
How much food can you possibly
eat? Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Hey, you're listening to the Golfin' Around Radio Hour here on Fox Sports Wheeling, Pittsburgh. I'm Tank, and coming to you from, well, the golf cart and the 19th hole here in Gaylord, the golf mecca. What's that website? GaylordTheGolfMecca.com?
No, GaylordGolfMecca.com. GaylordGolfMecca.com.
Say it.
GaylordGolfMecca.com.
GaylordGolfMecca.com. So that way when you get home, or if you're listening to this on the post podcast, just Google it on the old internet web search computer thing there.
Yeah, and if you can't remember that, just do Northern Michigan Golf Packages, and that'll pop up too.
Bingo. All right, so let's say you go ahead and you do that, which I want you to. Oh, by the way, since we're talking about Gaylord, Michigan, listen up if you like to win free stuff. Go to the Golfin' Around Facebook page. Golfin' Around Facebook page. You'll see my beautiful face, the old tanker there, and Jack Nicklaus and Arnold Palmer. Guess what? Go and like our Golfin' Around Facebook page. I'll look at the old metrics and the analytics.
All right.
The good folks up here in Gaylord have given me a beautiful Treetops golf hat. It's about $35 easily.
Oh, yeah.
And they gave me a Treetops golf towel. I've got two of them to give away throughout the course of the summer. Like my Golfin' Around Facebook page. And two of you out there, golfers, are going to win that Treetops hat and Treetop top. All right. So they go to the website.
Yep.
Golfin' Gaylord Golf Mecca.
Yeah.
What are they going to find? How many courses? What about the accommodations? Let's get into you had that big pork chop last night, Greg.
I had the big pork chop.
I had the salmon.
I'm still recovering from the pork chop.
Yeah, the salmon's trying to get out of my belly, flopping around. What are they going to discover? Two or three golf courses most?
We have 17 golf courses in our group. Three different resorts.
17.
Really, four different resorts. And then we have individual courses all around the area. It is really a golf mecca. 17 courses all within about 30 miles of each other, too. So you don't have to go very far. And if you go, it's just a scenic drive through the woods. It's not, you know, you're not going, you know, bumper-to-bumper traffic anywhere.
Right.
And it's, we have 21 lodging partners, including the place where you're staying at Otsego Resort.
Oh, love this. It looks like a Swiss chalet over there at the resort, folks. You'd love it. Gorgeous.
And then, so you have your choice. If you want a cabin with a fire pit out back, we can find you that. If you want a really nice hotel room with room service, we can find you that. If you want a resort that's a log cabin, you know, with everything polished and beautiful and you know, total country comfort. We can find you that. This is the place you're staying at. You stayed in at Otsego. Had a deck. It had a big great room in the middle with eight rooms around it for eight golfers to have a, you know, basically
a shindig.
Yeah, you can
play your cards.
It's your family game.
Lie about your golf score.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, one of the things I want to talk about is, so many times you go to, I don't want to beat up on Myrtle Beach, but I'm just using an example. You go out to golf, next thing you know, you slice, you hook one, and you got to go into Mrs. Such and Much's backyard to get your ball, and she's got a video camera and a sign that says, stay the hell out of my yard, or my Rottweiler's going to bite you right in the ass.
Yeah, we don't have any of those here.
Rottweilers. No, what they
no, there
don't.
There are Rottweilers.
There are Rottweilers.
But
what we
you don't see
have,
them.
Houses on the golf course.
Yeah, there's not too many of those. We only have a couple courses that even have houses anywhere near them, but that's because they're in resort retirement communities. But they built the golf courses first. The houses have all come in later, and they're like at least a, you know, well, it depends on how far you hit it, Tank. If you hit your 5-iron,
I'm consistent.
170 yards.
No.
You might be able to reach one of the houses.
No, I am so
consistent. You'd have to turn at the edge of the fairway and aim 170 yards to hit a
house. I'm so consistent. Off the tees, yeah. 120 to the left. Second shot from the fairway with a 5-wood.
Yeah.
120 yards to the left. Pitching wedge into the green. 82 yards. Elevated green. Pin tucked back to the right. I hit the pitching wedge 120 yards to the left. So I'm very concerned. It's time to putt. I line up the putt 120 yards to the left. Nobody has a more consistent golf swing.
You know your game.
Oh, yeah, it sucks. There.
You don't have any problem here. And you know, what you're more likely to see here is there's a place called Treetops because Robert Trent Jones, when he built the course, looked out over a par 3 that had a 150-foot drop and goes, all you see are treetops. And that became the name of the resort. And that's what you see up here. Today you're going to play a course called the Tribute that goes through the Sturgeon River Valley. Huge drops, all kinds of elevation changes. But it's not hard. It's big, wide fairways, big greens. And it's just gorgeous out there. And you're going to see more deer and more wild turkeys and critters on the banks of the ponds and stuff than you'll ever see other golfers. So.
You know, it is truly God's country up here in Gaylord, Michigan. It is gorgeous. The very fact that you do not have homes on the golf course, just nature abounds. Several resorts to talk about. I want to talk right now about the Gaylord Resort itself, where we stayed the other day, and some of the fine golf over there. How many golf courses? Four?
Oh, you stayed, five at Treetops Resort.
Treetops.
That's where you stayed.
I keep calling that one Treetops.
It's kind of synonymous with Gaylord, because it's right outside of town, but it's there's five golf courses, including the par 3 that called Treetops, which is one of the top-rated par 3s in the world.
Time out. If you folks have never enjoyed the majesty of a par 3, every hole's par 3.
Oh, yeah.
18 holes, you don't know what you're missing. This par 3 18 hole course at Treetops is phenomenal. Just ask Lee Trevino, because he won $1 million.
Yeah,
what was that event?
Well, they had a shootout. The ESPN teamed up with a guy named Rick Smith, who used to be
Pittsburgh guy.
He was Phil Mickelson's teacher, Billy Andrade, Rocco Media. He worked Lee Jansen. He worked with all those guys, and he was the first head golf professional here when they built the golf course with Robert Trent Jones back in the early, 35 years ago, exactly, actually. And he brought a lot of people here. He was an energetic guy, great guy, fantastic golfer. And we ended up with, becoming kind of a famous place. And he was an idea guy. He said, why can't we bring people to Northern Michigan? He had a great owner, a former industrialist from Detroit named Harry Melling. And Harry spent the money, and Rick knew how to spend it.
Well, that's the thing. You can have a guy with a vision, but if you got the guy with the money, too.
Yeah, it was really a perfect storm.
Four! Golfers, would you like to win a trip to Scotland? Then join us July 31st at the Wheeling Country Club for the Team USA Local Qualifier. Play in one of five handicap flights, win your flight, and you just might be on your way to Scotland. To register to play, log on to Team USA Worldwide Amateur Golf Championships.com or contact the Wheeling Country Club. Be there July 31st.
straight down the middle. It went straight down the middle. Then it started to hook just a wee bit. And that's when my caddy lost sight of it. That little